Last month, Little Mix made history by becoming the first female act ever to win a Brit Award for Best Group. They dedicated their award to all the girl bands that have paved the way for them, including the Spice Girls.
But what isn't widely known is that the Spice Girls looked very different when the band was originally formed, minus a certain baby Spice.
25 years ago, five young women released one of the biggest singles of the 90s. The Spice Girls became a global phenomenon. But this now iconic lineup could have been very different. Hundreds of hopefuls auditioned for the band, and some came tantalisingly close to being picked.
27 years ago, I was a full-time singer. I was singing in social clubs and I was singing with bands.
I got into singing when I was around 16 years of age. I carried that on at college and started auditioning.
I was doing my normal thing, which is flicking through the stage magazine every Thursday. And there it was, they were looking for five girls to form this girl group.
Young, fun, out there girls. It was the 90s, so it was quite a rebellious time.
And I thought, well, I could give that a go.
Nobody knew at the time, but this ad would lead to the formation of the Spice Girls. The ad was placed by 23-year-old aspiring pop manager Chris Herbert.
The trend very much at the time was boy bands. You know, we had had the success of Take That. I was going sort of to pubs and clubs and open mic nights, giving out my flyers for this girl band.
Lianne was one of hundreds of wannabe pop stars.
Coming from Cardiff and going to the Big Smoke, it was just an exciting thing.
Yeah, I was quite overwhelmed at how many people there were.
I was nervous, but I wasn't showing that I was nervous. I was quite mouthy, quite chatty, very Welsh.
Chris had a clear idea of what he was looking for.
We would do some improvised dance with them, just see that they could dance and move. And then we'd have them up one at a time doing their audition pieces.
Mel Coloma auditioned on March the 4th, 1994. Along with a few other familiar faces, including Victoria Beckham, Mel C and Mel B.
I remember Mel B walking in and I was like, well, that's a cert. She definitely cemented her place from the first time I met her.
Eventually, Chris made his final selections. Unfortunately for Mel Coloma, it wasn't good news.
Of course, I was gutted that I didn't get the job. I mean, anybody would be. After the audition, it was, OK, on to the next audition. That was it.
Lianne, though, was told she'd made it into the final lineup.
Getting picked for the last five was amazing. I was just waiting then for the letter to come because we were going to move into this house together.
But the letter never came.
She, in our mind, had a place in the band. Somewhere along that way, we switched her out and we brought Mel C in.
After serious consideration, they felt that I looked too old against the other girls. I would have been Old Spice.
It would be 2 years before Lianne and Mel and the rest of us saw those auditionees again.
I was sitting in my house and then Top of the Pops came on.
I looked at the screen and I said, I know those girls.
And there they were, singing Wannabe.
Lianne and Mel may not have made it onto Top of the Pops, but Lianne did go on to have a recording and performing career. After overcoming a serious vocal condition, she continues to sing and is now an artist and music teacher.
If things would have been different and the door would have slid in another way, I wouldn't have been given the opportunity to have an impact on young people as I have.
Mel Coloma also continues to sing and now works for the NHS, ordering PPE for medical staff.
It is rewarding and I'm proud to be working for the NHS.
Chris went on to be a successful manager, overseeing the careers of bands including Five, Hearsay and Bewitched.
We literally started at ground zero and we all went our separate ways and we became successful. And for that, I'm proud of us all.
Wasn't that brilliant?
Fine lines,
who
eh?
Who knew? I mean, Lianne? Emma, that could have been your bandmate.
I just, it's so crazy watching. In fact, I was with Victoria this weekend and we spoke about the audition process, and I wasn't in that audition process, but I sang SWV right here for mine, and she sang Mine Hair, and I was like, mine's cooler, sorry. but yeah, I mean, just crazy, isn't it? Just crazy how it all happened.
And did you get in quite quickly? I mean, did the process, you know, happen quite quick?
So the girls were together and I had a singing teacher at college, and she said, oh, there's a band together and they want another girl to join them.
Right.
And I remember having a call with Chris and he said, oh, but are you, how tall, you know, are you over 5'3" and can you sing? All this kind of questions. And I thought, I'm not, I'm 5'1". So I literally went out and bought myself the first pair of buffalo boots just so that I could be 5'3". That is an absolute true story. Me and my mum went to Covent Garden and bought me some big buffalo so I could look at 5'3".
Well, it worked.
So lucky. It worked.
Yeah.
I got it.
Great idea.
I auditioned and then I moved in with the girls, you know, 2 days later, I think.
Absolutely love it.